Hello, a very good day to you. My name is Sister Temitayo, and I'm here once again to share the Open Heavens Daily Devotional with you. Now, the Open Heavens Daily Devotional that I'm sharing is this one that is compiled by the General Overseer of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, Pastor E.A. Adeboye. Now, if you're visiting my channel for the very first time, or if you know me personally, you'll be asking, Sister Tayo, why are you sharing this particular daily devotional? Why not another one? Because there are many great Christian daily devotionals out there. Well, the reason why I'm sharing this particular daily devotional is because as I prepared to enter into the year 2020, which was last year, the Spirit of God instructed me to begin to share this particular daily devotional on YouTube, to be very specific. And I was able to start that assignment in the month of June 2020. I shared the devotional not only in June, but also in August, in October, and in December 2020. And in this year 2021, I resumed sharing in the months of March, May. I shared in July, I'm sharing now in September, and I'll also be sharing in November 2021 by the grace of God. And I thank God for the grace to share. Amen. Now, all those videos from June 2020 last year are all loaded on my YouTube channel. So I will encourage you to visit the channel, you know, and you will definitely find a topic that inspires you. And I know when you listen to it, because it's the word of God and is inspired by the Holy Spirit, it will definitely bless you. Even though I'm the one who shared the word, I still go back and I listen, and I'm still blessed over and over again. Amen. And I'm sure you too will be blessed as well. Now, how did I get to know Pastor Adeboye? Pastor Adeboye led me to Christ in October 1997, many years ago, when I was an undergraduate in the University of Lagos in Nigeria in West Africa. And Pastor Adeboye's style of teaching is that he will give you a few scriptures to read. He will give you a memory verse. And when you combine those two pieces of scripture, it helps you to understand the body of the daily devotional and what he's trying to communicate to the reader by the Spirit of God. Amen. Praise God. You know, the Bible says God sent his word. It healed them and delivered them from destruction. So every day God sends his word to us through the daily devotional. Now let's go straight into the reading. Today is Sunday, September the 5th. And the title of today's reading is All Around Peace, Part 2. We shared Part 1 yesterday. And I know today, as to say, today is Sunday, you're probably in person in church, or you're watching online. But whichever way, you're going to be blessed by the word today. And God would cause you to hear a word behind the word of the prophet saying this is the way, walking it. So it's great to come to church. All Around Peace, Part 2. Our scriptural reading is taken from the book of Hebrews chapter 12, verses 14 and 15. Hebrews chapter 12, verses 14 and 15. Hebrews in the New Testament. And we're reading just two verses. I'll read from the traditional King James Version. It's fairly easy to understand, and I'll also explain. And thus goes the reading of God's word. Follow peace with all men, and holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. Looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness springing up trouble you, and thereby many be defiled. Follow peace with all men. Another translation says pursue peace. You know, you are pursuing peace, you know, with all men. And holiness, not only holiness, you know. You know, some people say pursue holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. The Bible is saying that you should pursue, follow peace with all men and holiness without which no man shall see the Lord. So, in other words, somebody has offended you, the person is wrong and is picking a grudge against you. You are the one that will go and apologize, because God is saying that we should pursue peace with all men. You say to the person, I'm sorry. If I offended you, please forgive me. I'm a Christian and I don't want to fight you. I hope that we can agree, you know, disagree to agree, because I'm pursuing peace with all men and holiness, because I want to see God and because I don't want to fail. The Bible says, looking diligently, lest any man fail of the grace of God, lest any root of bitterness or resentment springing up trouble him, by which many are defiled. So people think they are defiled when they eat pork, but no, that's not true. God is saying here that the root of bitterness can cause a person to be defiled and cause the grace of God to fail in his life. So you must look diligently and understand that when you are becoming bitter, it is Satan wanting to cause the root of bitterness to, is a seed that he wants to cause to grow in your heart. You must recognize it and you must attack it in the name of Jesus Christ. For some people, they are not easily offended, but when somebody has really, really hurt you, genuinely hurt you, and you are the one who has been offended, and you are beginning to feel bitter, you are becoming angry, it will lead to, you know, you have to fight it. And you go on your knees and say, God, this person has done this and this to me. Help me not to be bitter. Help me to forgive. I come against the spirit of bitterness in the name of Jesus Christ. I refuse to be bitter. Amen. Let's go straight into the daily devotional. All around peace. And Pastor says, peace is an essential ingredient for progress. It is an important factor for a man's well-being and good health. Pastor says that our God is the author and controller of peace. There is the peace that comes from the condition of our environment, whether physical or non-physical. And then the fact that somebody is a child of God and love him does not necessarily mean such a person will not have problems. Fear takes away a person's peace, but when you put your trust in God, he keeps you in perfect peace. Isaiah chapter 26 verse 3, he keeps you in perfect peace. Shalom, shalom, peace with prosperity. This perfect peace comes only through surrendering one's life to Jesus Christ, as per Romans 5 verse 1. You know, without peace, there can be no progress and there cannot be development, you know. And I said yesterday that the opposite of peace is stress. You know, where there's no peace, if there's no peace at home, if there's no peace on your job where you work 8 hours, it can lead to stress. Amen. You know, and Pastor is reminding us that where there's no peace, there's no progress. You know, everybody deserves peace of mind. Jesus Christ is our peace, Prince of Peace. He says that fear takes away peace, but when you put your trust in God, you know, he keeps you in perfect peace because your mind is stayed on him. Shalom, shalom. Then he says something very important. He says that perfect peace comes only through surrendering one's life to Jesus Christ, as per Romans 5:1, which says that we are now justified by faith and we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. So if you're not born again, you're not at peace with God. God is not, that's what the Bible is saying. It's only through faith in Jesus Christ that we are made, peace is made with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. So there is no discussion between God and the sinner. But when you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, he settles the quarrel between you and God. Amen. You are justified by faith and you are now at peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. So are you at peace with God? Are you born again? Mm-hmm. So Jesus Christ is the mediator. The Bible says that he's the Prince of Peace and he has broken down the middle wall of partition. Amen. And has made us one with the Father. Pastor says, there is, however, something that can keep the children of God from experiencing the peace of God, the root of bitterness. While this root of bitterness could affect a fellow person's behavior towards those against whom he is harboring such a feeling, the more dangerous effect of it is ultimately felt by the bitter person. Bitterness in the heart of a person creates room for hatred, envy, and anger. It breeds unforgiveness and unhappiness. Indeed, the word bitterness itself depicts what it offers, a bitter experience. It hinders the flow of joy and peace. And you know, when Satan is so wicked, when somebody is going to offend you, to be somebody maybe from church, it may be your brother, your sister, the same mother, the same father, you know, your very close friend, you know. And but Pastor is warning us that there's something that can hinder all-round peace, and that is the root of bitterness and resentment, you know. And what he's saying here is that it ultimately, the dangerous effect of bitterness, it affects the person who is bitter, who has been offended, who has been genuinely offended. It can lead to hatred, envy, and anger. It can lead to unforgiveness and unhappiness. And, you know, it will hinder joy and peace. You know, so you've been genuinely offended. Somebody has really hurt you genuinely. And you're hurt. You know, if you allow Satan to take a hold of that feeling and you begin to judge, your mind is just running away, that if you have a knife, you will kill the person. You know, if you don't take hold of that thought and say, no, 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 in the name of Jesus, I refuse to be bitter. I pursue peace with all men and holiness. And you take a hold of it by the blood of Jesus, because it's an evil thing. The Bible says it can cause the grace of God to fail in the life of a man. It can defy a man. You know, so Pastor then says, how does it originate? It comes when one feels unfairly treated by another person or an organization. It's a feeling of being injured, whether physically or otherwise. Examples will include a sister being jilted in courtship, a fellow catching his or her spouse in adultery, an employee being shortchanged by his or her organization, a person being raped, and so on. you know, these are genuine offenses. And, you know, maybe your future the future husband or wife, you know, abandons the person at the altar. That is a reason to be genuinely bitter. But pastor is saying that you have to be very, very careful. You know, those are, you have to, for some people, you know, they just take it. They're not really, you can't offend them. But when you find that you're emotional and that thing has hurt you deeply, I said to you, take it to God in prayer and be honest with God and say, Father, this person hurt me. He hurt me. But never say, I cannot forgive. No. Don't say that. Don't let it come out of your mouth. Commit it into the hands of God and say, this person hurt me. Father, it's hard. I can't forgive him on my own. I need your grace. I need your spirit. I need you to help me. Give me grace to forgive, because I don't want to be defiled and I don't want to fall short of the grace of God. You are wrestling and forbidding that spirit from taking hold in your heart. David said, search me and know my heart. Try me and know my anxieties. See if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting, in Psalm 139. You must, by the Spirit of God, forgive that person no matter the offense. And I said to the person who is causing the offense, Jesus said that woe unto him through whom offenses come. It would be better that a millstone was tied around his neck and he was put into the water than for him to offend one of these little ones. So just because you have hurt somebody, you think that, oh, you are going scot-free. Jesus Christ said it's better that a millstone was cast around your neck and you are thrown into the sea. May the Lord help us in Jesus' name. Pastor says, are you battling against the root of bitterness resulting from some experience or the other? Please note that it is not in your interest to harbor it. Bitterness eats its host up. It negatively affects the physical well-being of the individual, as well as causing a strained relationship with God. Amen. You have to fight it by the Spirit of God. It's not by power or by might, but by my Spirit, saith the Lord of hosts. You know, and if that person is continually causing you offense, you know, love them from afar. Love them from afar. Have no bitterness against them. In fact, you can even pray for them. And pray for them and pray that God will change them. When you start praying for somebody who is offending you, amen, you know, God gives you the grace. God enables you. Become bigger in your spirit. Praise God. You know, and it's not by power or by might, but by the Spirit of God, I say to you, praise God. Pastor says, now, pastor is giving an example of, these are genuine legal reasons for you to be offended. Pastor says, you may have heard me tell the story of a man whose wife had died, leaving behind an only daughter with a striking resemblance to her mother. The daughter was a great consolation to the man, but the lady's husband was constantly maltreating the lady to the point of threatening her life. The root of bitterness that sprang up in the lady's father resulted in him becoming swollen, defying all medical care. He only became healed after forgiving his son-in-law. To retain your God-given peace, remove all forms of bitterness in your heart today. And pastor is giving this is a very, you know, a father lost his wife. His daughter reminded him so much of his wife. He loved her, but her husband maltreated her, you know, to the point that he threatened her life, maybe with domestic violence. And because of that, the father hated his son-in-law so much that it caused sickness in his own body, you know, and he began to swell until he was able to bring himself to forgive his son-in-law. That was the only time that he was healed. Okay, so pastor was saying that bitterness eats up the host. Now this is a genuine reason. If somebody is attacking your child and beating up your child, you know, that's a reason to hate the person. But if it's causing bitterness, then you have to fight it and forgive that person and pray that God will remove that bitterness so that you will not be defiled. Amen. And I said to you, you know, if maybe you're an employee in an office and you've worked so hard, and the promotion passed you by and they didn't give it to you, they gave it to somebody who is not qualified, don't worry. Are you a Christian? If you're a Christian, all things work together for your good because you love God, because you are the called according to his purpose. Have they made you redundant? You know, they've done pulled the chair from under you and pulled the carpet from under you. Are you a Christian? All things work together for your good because you love God and because you are the called according to your purpose. Is there anybody who has been jilted? You know, you've invested so much in that relationship and that man or that woman left you and just duped you and just did so many terrible things. I say to you, are you a Christian? Don't worry. All things work together for your good because you love God, because you are the called according to your purpose. And remember, you can talk to your pastor, the one that God has anointed to help you. Amen. Now, the action point says, check your heart to ensure that bitterness is not lurking in there. If you find any trace of such, let go of it and pray for the healing of your soul. Prayer is the key. Amen. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you. We thank you for the grace to look diligently so that no root of bitterness springing up can trouble us, and that by which many are defiled. Father, we pray for the grace to forgive and forgive totally in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. We forgive all those that have offended us. We uproot the root of bitterness in our hearts in the name of Jesus Christ. We forgive by the blood of Jesus as we have forgiven those who have trespassed against us in Jesus' name. We refuse to be offended. We love all in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Thank you, because the love of God that is shed abroad in our heart is greater than all. We refuse to be offended in Jesus' mighty name. Amen. Thank you very much for taking time to listen to me. I hope this was not too long. Please don't forget to subscribe to my channel, and I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. May God bless you exceedingly. My name again is Sister Temitayo, and God bless you.